Hi friends, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudoku and Puzzles. Ashish here, and today I'll be covering a puzzle genre called sunglasses puzzle. Now today we'll be solving two puzzles on our channel, and both of these puzzles were featured on gmpuzzles.com. And as you know, GM Puzzles is an excellent website for Sudokus and puzzles, and there are excellent authors who provide puzzles over there. And there is an ebook store where you have excellent many ebooks of different puzzle genres and even Sudokus, so you can check them out and even buy them, because I would really suggest you, there are excellent puzzles there. So I'll add the link in the description below for the GM Puzzles website, the ebook store, and as well as the puzzles that we are solving today, the online interface of the link, the link of the online interface of the puzzle that we are solving today. So the two puzzles that we are solving, the first puzzle is by Eden and the second puzzle is by Yuki Kawabe. So it's a really different puzzle genre, and it comes into the shading puzzle category. So now, before going to the puzzle, I would really suggest you to check out the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. That will really motivate us to cover videos on daily basis. And if at all you have a request for any puzzle genre or a Sudoku variant, do let us know in the comment below and we'll surely make a video on it. And now, coming on to the puzzle, we need to shade some cells in the grid such that they form sunglasses. Now, what is a sunglass? So sunglass is nothing but it consists of a bridge, right? One bridge here, so the red line is a bridge, and then two lenses made out of orthogonally connected black cells, right? So the one end of the bridge is one lens, and the other end of the bridge is the other lens. So the lens is formed from this one end and the other end, two ends, right? And both the lenses are symmetrically equal with respect to the perpendicular bisector of the bridge. So the perpendicular bisector is this line, right? So this is the perpendicular bisector. So if it's nothing like, you just have this line, and we'll just turn this line, and both of the lenses will exactly overlap with each other, right? So for example, I will just show you an image here of how the lens would be. So as you can see here, this is one of the sunglasses, a bridge and two lenses here. And as you can see, these two lenses, if we just, you know, cut this bridge into half and just turn this way, the two regions will exactly overlap with each other, right? So that is what the puzzle says. And there are some digits outside the grid. So the digits indicates the number of shaded cells which are part of the lenses, right? The shaded cells in the particular row and column. And each of the lenses will not touch each other. Even the lenses of the same sunglasses won't touch each other orthogonally, but they can touch each other diagonally. And even the lenses of each the other sunglasses. So for example, this is the lens of the other sunglass. It cannot touch this sunglasses or this lens, and the lenses here as well. So these two lenses also cannot touch each other orthogonally. They can touch each other diagonally, but not orthogonally. And with that, we'll start solving this puzzle. So the lenses always start from the end point of the bridge. So these are the end points, right? So this would have to be shaded. And always keep in mind that the middle part of the lens, or I mean to say the middle part of the bridge, will always be unshaded. And as we already know that the lenses of different bridges also cannot touch each other orthogonally. So this would have to be unshaded. And so as you can see here, for this lens, there are three orthogonally unshaded white cells, which means that the perpendicular this lens, the exactly this lens will also have three unshaded white cells orthogonal to it. And would have to be these three cells, right? It would have to be these three cells. That's it. And so if you shade this cell will also be shaded, because they are symmetrically equal in with the perpendicular bisector of the bridge. There is one excellent technique here, excellent trick here, I would say, is, so for this bridge, this is the perpendicular bisector, right? This is this angle is the perpendicular bisector. And so seeing this angle, these cells, exactly the perpendicular bisector cells of this bridge, will never be shaded for its own lenses. That's an excellent logic here, and it's actually trick I would say is, because if this cell is shaded for this sunglasses, both of which will touch each other orthogonally, which is not possible, right? So for the particular sunglass, the perpendicular bisector cells will never be shaded. That's a really good trick here, and this trick will help you to unshade this cell, because if you shade this cell, both of these will be shaded and then the lenses are touching each other, not possible, right? And okay, so that's till this we have done. Now as you can see here, okay, this is possible. So there's a good logic here with the 5 here. What happens if this is unshaded? So all the other cells would have to be shaded, and then what happens here is that all these 4 cells also will have to be shaded. Not possible, right? So in other words, I can say is, for this lens, the third cell is the unshaded cell. So for this lens, till the third cell, you can never be all these 3 cells shaded, which means that one of these 3 cells will have to be unshaded. All these 3 cells cannot be shaded, right? Which means that all these 3 cells also cannot be shaded. So there will be one unshaded cell in one of these 3 cells. So the other 2 cells would have to be shaded to make sure that the 5 is fulfilled. One cell is also already shaded, right? Which means that out of these 5, 4 would have to be shaded. And which means that one of the unshaded cells is in one of these 3 cells, right? Which means that both of these cells will have to be unshaded, shaded. Okay. Okay, and anything else we get here? So 6 cells. Okay, that was a very easy one that we have missed. 6 cells will be all 6 cells shaded here, right? Which means that this is formed this way. So exactly, it has to be symmetrical for the other lens too. So this will be shaded and both of these also will be shaded, right? Okay, so this is unshaded and this also will be unshaded because the 2 lenses are of different sunglasses and cannot touch each other. So this is also unshaded, which means this will have to be shaded for the 5 to be fulfilled, which means this would have to be shaded for the lens to be symmetrical. And okay, so this 6 is fulfilled, this 5 is fulfilled, right? And now this 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Will this go up? If it doesn't go up, it will have to be this way, right? Possible. It is still possible. So let's see anything else we get. Okay. That's an excellent logic here with this 5. If all of these 3 are shaded, all of these 3 also will be shaded, and you have 2 lenses, different lenses touching each other, not possible, right? Which means that one of the unshaded cells would have to be in these 3 cells. So this cell would have to be shaded and this cell is shaded now. Nice logic here again. And so for this lens, this cell is unshaded, so this cell would have to be unshaded, right? Okay. And for this lens, this cell is unshaded, so for this lens, this cell would have to be unshaded again. Nice logic. Okay. For the 6 again, I'm sorry, we just removed these 3 shaded cells. That was not supposed to be removed. And let's see if we are missing any other logic here. It seems to be a very good puzzle. And okay. So this cell, that's a really nice logic. Can this cell be shaded? So if this cell is shaded, what sunglass would be part of this cell? I mean to say, this shaded cell will go to which lens? It is not possible to this lens, because then all these 3 and these 3 will be shaded. Not possible, right? And if it cannot go to this lens as well, because then this cell also would have to be shaded, right? Symmetrical cell for this sunglass, not possible. Which means that this cell would have to be unshaded. And now for the 5 here, these two cells would have to be shaded. That makes these two cells also as shaded cells. Excellent logic, guys. What an excellent logic this is. And now with that, okay, so with that, we know that one of these two cells would have to be shaded, right, for the 5 to be fulfilled. 1, 2, 3, 4. So at least one of these two cells would have to be shaded, right? Which means that that shaded cell will be part of this lens. Which means that you can extend both of these lenses, and that makes the symmetrical lens here. Nice. So this will be unshaded, this will be unshaded. So one of the sunglasses is already fulfilled, right? No, it cannot be extended anyway. And this lens cannot go down now, so it cannot go up as well in the symmetrical area. And now this 5 has to be fulfilled, right? And can only be fulfilled with one of the shaded cells here. And that shaded cell will have to be part of the this sunglasses, right? So you can extend here as well. And extend one more, because the 5 has to be fulfilled. So if you don't extend here, the 5 cannot be fulfilled, right? Not possible. So this would have to be extended, and that unshades this cell and this cell as well. This cell as well. And this 5 is fulfilled by shading this cell. That shades this cell. What a fun puzzle this is, guys. What an excellent puzzle this was. Very fun puzzle, right? Something very different logic used in this kind of puzzles. A very different genre, I would say. Something new puzzle genre. And a fun puzzle, I would say. So with that, we'll solve the other puzzle now. The other puzzle is by Yuki Kawabe. And Yuki Kawabe is an excellent author, I would say. He has constructed some excellent puzzles in the past, and has authored many championships. I would say many online events, I would say. So with that, we'll start solving this puzzle. Okay, so we can just shade the corner cells of the bridges as usual, and unshade the middle cells of the bridges as usual, right? The first trick is this one. The second trick would be that these two cells would be unshaded, because if it is shaded, it will have to be part of this sunglasses, which is not possible, right? Because it is a perpendicular bisector cell of that sunglass. Okay. And if you see the 8 here, that is the start of the puzzle, I would say. All of these 5 cells cannot be shaded, because what happens is that both of these lenses are touching each other. So there will be an unshaded cell in this 5 cells, which means that all other cells would have to be shaded, because it's a 10 by 10 grid, right? So there are 10 cells in a row, out of which one cell is already unshaded, and the other cell unshaded would be in one of these 5 cells. So all of the other cells would have to be shaded and unshade this cell, because now this cannot be extended towards the left, so it cannot be extended towards the right. So these two and these two will be shaded here. Okay, that makes this cell as unshaded because of the symmetrical lens. So the 8 is fulfilled now. Okay. So that unshades this cell as well, right? Because of the symmetrical lens here for this lens, right? And oh, that's an excellent logic. That's a very good logic, guys. That's a very good logic here. And what happens if you unshade this cell? All of the white cells would have to be shaded now, which means that both of these lenses are touching each other. So this would be a shaded, this would be shaded. And what happens if one of these two cells are unshaded? The same logic. All of these cells would have to be shaded, right? Which means that both of these cells are shaded, right? And that is an excellent logic here, guys. Because what happens is this. This shaded cell will be part of one of the sunglasses. And that cannot be this sunglass, because the symmetrical shaded cell for this sunglass would have to be these two cells, which is already part of this sunglass. Which means that this shaded cell will have to be part of this sunglasses. And which means that these two cells will also have to be shaded for the symmetrical this lens. So we are not sure that how the connection would be. It can be any way like this, right? But we are sure that if these two shaded cells are part of this lens, then these two shaded cells will have to be part of this lens. What an excellent logic. Superb. And so for the 3 to be fulfilled, only one of these cells will have to be shared, right? That is a really, really difficult one to see. So let's see if we get anything else. So as we can already say that this cell would have to be unshared because it is a symmetrical bisector for this sunglasses and no other sunglass can take this cell. And that gives a very good logic, guys. Awesome. Let me see if that is possible. That's a really good logic here. Okay, I got the logic. Awesome logic, guys. So if you see here, can this cell be shaded? If this cell is shaded, it cannot be part of this sunglass, right? Of course, because it is the perpendicular bisector cell, which is not possible. So it cannot connect to both of these lenses. And if this cell is shaded, then there is only one sunglass that it can connect to, which is this sunglasses, right? So if this cell is shaded, it would have to be part of this sunglasses, which means that the symmetrical shaded cell would have to be this, right? 1, 2, 3 left, 1, 2, 3 left down, which means that this cell cannot be shaded now. And why this is helpful is, now let me show you the logic. That's a really good logic here. Whenever you have a diagonal bridge for the sunglasses, right? Each a row and column can have only one shaded cell in for the diagonal bridge. So in other words, I would say there is already one shaded cell for this row 5, right? There is already one shaded cell for this 5, and there has to be exactly 4 more shaded cells. And what happens if you shade this cell? The moment you shade this cell would be shaded, and there are 3 more cells that has to be shaded in this row, which is not at all possible, because if you shade this cell will be shaded. And if you shade both the cells, both the cells will be shaded. So only even number of shaded cells are possible if you have a horizontal sunglass, right? And if you see the horizontal clue simultaneously. So if there is a horizontal sunglass and above which if you have an horizontal clue, then that sunglass can only have even number of shaded cells for that clue. So you exactly have, if you shade this cell, you exactly have 3 cells to be shaded, and that is not possible with the horizontal bridge here, which means that this cell would have to be unshaded and this cell also would have to be unshaded. What an excellent piece of logic here. What an excellent piece of logic. And with that, we have to shade all of the other cells here, and that unshades this cell, and this would have to go this way. There is no other way that this shaded cell and this shaded cell can be connected. Both of these will be unshaded, so all of these will be unshaded, and this is unshaded, so this is also unshaded. And for the 3 to be fulfilled, you have only one shaded cell remaining, so the symmetrical shaded cell would have to be this. And now we have fulfilled one of the sunglasses here. Excellent logic. Wow, I would say wow, nothing else. I cannot say furthermore for this logic. And I can see that the 3 uses the same logic that we have used for 5. You need exactly 2 cells that has to be shaded, and the diagonal one cannot come up. So there has to be a shaded cell that will be from this sunglass only. You cannot have from this sunglass as well. Not possible. This is unshaded, right? So it cannot be possible from this sunglass and this sunglass as well, because this sunglass will have only one cell that can come towards this cell. That is possible, which is again not possible because that would violate the 3. So there is exactly one shaded cell from both of these lenses that will come down, right? For the 3 to be fulfilled. Okay. Let us see if we get anything else. And that fulfills the 5 actually. So all of these 2 cells cannot be shaded because that will shade both of these cells. So you will have one unshaded cell here, which means all the other cells would have to be shaded. That's nice again. So you have only one more cell to be fulfilled. And it cannot be this cell. Superb. It cannot be this cell. Because if it is this cell, this would have to be unshaded. And we know that this will also come up. And we already know that for the three to be fulfilled, there has to be a share itself from these two sunglasses and not this sunglasses. Not at all possible. Which means this would have to be unshared, this is shared, this is shared, this is unshared, and this is unshared. Excellent logic. And all of these are unshared now. Which unshares this cell for this lens exactly. So three is yet to be fulfilled, okay? And one more good logic here. This four can only be fulfilled by this sunglass now. Because there is not possible that you will have a shaded cell from this sun lens till the 4 clue, because all of the path are blocked. So which means that the 4 needs only one more shaded cell and it will have to be from this sunglass, right? Okay. This will be unshaded. And this will be unshaded because this cannot come towards the 3. It has to be only this sunglasses. This lens that has to come towards this point, right? Not possible again. So the 5 is fulfilled. The 3 is fulfilled. Let's see with the 6 now. 1, 2, 3, 4. Two more cells to be fulfilled, right? Can it be these two cells? Not possible, right? Then for this lens, it would have to be these two cells. Not possible, right? Because these two lenses cannot come down, right? So which means that this cell will have to be shaded. It cannot be unshaded. So this cell, okay, sorry. This cell would have to be shaded. We marked wrong there. And okay. So can this cell be shaded and this be unshaded? If this is shaded, it will have to be part of this sunglasses, right? Not this. Because not possible. Because this shaded cell, the symmetrical shaded cell for this lens would have to be this, which is not possible. So this lens would have to be part of this sunglasses, which makes this cell as shaded for this sun lens. Not possible. So this cell cannot be shaded. This cell would have to be shaded. Excellent. It's kind of an elimination logic, but it's really a good one, I would say. And for the 7 now, can anything be done? For the 6, this both can be shaded, not sure. Can this be shaded? No, because that would be part of either this lens, which is not possible, and part of this lens is a perpendicular bisector cell, not possible. So this is not this is unshaded, which means that this cell cannot be part of any sunglass, because it cannot be part of this sunglass as well and this sunglass as well. Not possible. Okay. And which means that one of these two cells will have to be shaded for the 4 to be fulfilled. And it can be part of only this sunglasses, this lens. Excellent. So which means that this cell cannot be shaded, because these two cells would have to be shaded. Not possible, right? So this cell would have to be shaded. That comes down this way. And this lens is also fulfilled now. Okay, this can be, this is unshaded. Now this is unshaded. For the 3 to be fulfilled, both of these will be shaded. And now if 6 is fulfilled, 6 is also fulfilled, so these both will have to be unshared. What an excellent puzzle this was. What an excellent puzzle. Both of the puzzles were excellent here. And I really enjoyed solving both of these puzzles, sunglasses puzzles. Really a different kind of puzzle genre. And this is what I love about GM puzzles, because their selection of puzzles is really, really excellent. And it has really high quality. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you have got something about sunglasses, and it's a really new puzzle type. Do like and comment if you want us to solve any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre. And don't forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you.